all packed up. I'm ready to go. It's 6:17 in the morning. I'm hoping to get there within the next 20 minutes, half an hour. So this is the start of my Florida trip, I suppose. Hopefully I'm all right. So far, so good. I'm a little bit nervous, but that's normal, I guess. So yeah, I gotta get to the airport because they wouldn't let me check in ahead of time. So hopefully that doesn't mean bad news. I guess I'll keep you updated on that. But other than that, I'm just waiting for Dawn to get back in the car and then we'll be on our way. See you at the airport. All right, I made it. Heading in. Gotta go check in. Hopefully I have a seat. I paid for one, so shit. Yeah. Here we go. Well, I got through checkpoint unscathed. Now I get to go to my gate and hang out till boarding pass. So I found out it says see agent for my seat in Chicago, so I'm a little bit nervous about that. But I guess we'll find out whenever we get there. So, not too busy today, which is great. So we're just heading to gate F. Alright. Hopefully not too far because Orlando. Let's see. Alright, just an update. I got a seat. I'm in the middle, which is not ideal, but it is what it is. I'm on one of the big planes heading to Orlando. Gotta go to gate C15. Looks like I'm gonna be on time. So we'll see. I gotta find it first though. We'll see. I went the wrong way. Hopefully that doesn't mean I'm not gonna make it. But I guess I need to get a shuttle over to gate C. Alright. Turns out it's just a cool little underground walk with funky lights, which is kind of cool. Now if I can get to my gate quick enough and drop off my stuff, then I want to get something to eat and then get on the next flight. Looks like I got an economy plus seat. Find budget car rental as well as get a SIM card from iMobile. I just gotta get on the internet and find that, pick up my car, go buy a tent, and then I'll be on the way to go camping. Figure out where all that is in a moment. It's pretty nice in here. So yeah, let me get that situated and then I'll catch up with you guys later.
Small business.
I had to take a subway train or something to the main terminal to come to the little iMotion. So the iMotion that you get off at is not the one you get the card at. You need to come to the main terminal. So here I am. Hopefully I'm able to find it. We'll see. Okay, I got across the street to get into the garage to pick up my car. They tried to give me like an F-150 pickup truck, but I didn't want that because I'm just not comfortable driving that big of a vehicle in the town I don't know. So instead, I guess they're giving me a Challenger. Holy shit. So I guess I'm going fancy, but I'll show you the car whenever I get there, I suppose. And then check for any scratches, damages, and then get out. Well, I might be all over the place, but I took back the charger because I didn't want to pay an extra like 150 Canadian for a charger. I'll just drive the freaking pickup truck. I don't want to be rolling up at a campsite in a Dodge Charger anyways. I mean, it would have been nice, but hey, we'll see what I got and save myself some money. Not if I can drive the van in Iceland and stuff like that, I don't see why I can't drive a pickup truck. I think I'm just intimidated right now because I'm by myself. But here we go. This is the final swap. I ain't doing it again. So going from a Charger to a pickup truck from what I was supposed to get originally. All right, I'll show you the vehicle and then get my stuff in there. Well, here she is. Q21. My ride for the next 6 days. Oh my word. All right, I'm gonna do a quick walk around. Big ass vehicle for just me, I can tell you that. Oh, crap. I'm a little bit intimidated to drive this thing, but look at this. Got the keys. Keep that in there, I guess. Whew. It is hot and humid. I don't know how I'm gonna sleep, but we'll see. I kind of don't like how they don't come with you and do the whole paper thing like they normally do, but yeah, I don't see any issues. Looks like it's a brand new truck, pretty much. Never again am I going mystery car, to tell you that, because it's between this and a big ass charger, which, I don't know, I'm not feeling that badass. We'll see. Okay, I'm gonna get in, and I guess I'm gonna go. I gotta go get something to eat, because I'm starting to feel sick from not eating. And then I'll pick these up once I decide what's going on. Here we go, my big ass truck. Gotta get out of here because there's no signal. Boy, oh boy. I don't know what I got myself into. Okay, there's the exit. I'm in a massive truck. Like, why did I do this? I'm paying extra. Never again am I ever getting a mystery car. I can tell you that because I need a car. Like, I am not comfortable at all. Okay, I gotta put the camera away. I'll pick you up whenever I get to a food place or someone with signal. Well, you can tell you're not in Canada anymore. So far, so good though. I think I'm okay in this truck. Just gotta watch myself and pay attention. Nice palm trees around. Heading to the campsite. Well, I got my tent, gas, and everything. Look at the palm trees, eh? Dicks, and now I'm just heading to Walmart for some water and stuff, and then I'm heading off to the campsite. So I'll see you once I get there. I'll try to film like some stuff as I'm going to show you the like locale and whatnot, but I gotta concentrate on driving, so I'll catch you later. I finally made it to Wakiwa Springs, if I'm pronouncing it properly. Wow, what an entrance. I guess I gotta get checked in for the campsite and then I will pick this back up after I talk to the guy, because I don't know if he'll appreciate me filming, so let me just get this going and then I'll pick you back up. Okay, so looks like there's more sites available, so I might stay here tomorrow as well. I'm not sure. Campground this way. But look at this. This is just gorgeous. Look at the plants and everything. So we're in campsite number 9. Hopefully I can get in there and situate it before it gets too dark, because it's already pretty getting dark now. But we'll find out in a moment, I suppose. finally made it to a destination where I can chill and relax. It is super humid outside, so I don't know how I'm going to be able to sleep tonight. We'll find out. I bought a fan for the tent. But wish me luck, because if it's not good tonight, then I'm going to have one heck of a week. So maybe I'll have to nap throughout the day or something. Who knows? But yeah, so just driving in here now. Walking trails throughout here. I don't mind filming while driving here because there's nobody here. And yeah, look at that. Beautiful. So, okay, let me pull in and I'll set you up and get the tent going, and then I gotta cook something to eat and then hopefully get a good night's rest tonight. All right. Well, I'm in the tent, got everything in here, got bit by some bugs already, forgot that maybe I should have bought bug spray, but you know, it is what it is. I'm already sticky as hell. Hopefully this little fan that I got here, it's noisy, but it's going to have to do. Hopefully it does some justice and I'll be able to sleep. All I got is a sleeping bag to sleep on, no foam or air mattress or anything, so yeah. I didn't want to spend the extra money on a blow-up mattress or anything, so it is what it is. Haven't eaten much today, so I don't know how that's going to do, but I don't think I can cook anything tonight. I'm just going to try to go to bed, basically. It's already dark outside, as you can see here, so just going to play on the phone, maybe listen to some music, and get up in the morning and check out the springs. All right, I'll catch you in the AM. Bye. Well, good morning. Had an alright sleep, actually, considering. Now I'm just walking to the bathroom, checking out. Gotta use the washroom, then I'll make myself some oatmeal, and then after that I think I'm gonna go check out the springs. So okay, stay tuned for that. This is the bathroom facility here. Not too shabby, I guess. At least it's a building and not an outhouse. But beautiful campsite. I really gotta decide what I'm gonna do tonight though. I think I'm gonna take a walk to the gate with my card and see if I could spend another night here. And yeah. So I'll keep you updated with what I'm doing. Let me go to the washroom and then I'll show you my little abode. We took it back there. All right, so this is my little setup. Got my tent here amongst the pines and the palms. They got like electricity hookups, but I don't need that. They got a fire pit in the back, but I don't have any wood to burn that either, so it's fine. Okay, so now I'm just gonna get my oatmeal set up and then I'm gonna take a walk and go check out the springs. All right, I'll bring you along whenever I do that. Well, I think I'm gonna pack up the tent first since it's supposed to rain later. I'm gonna wait till 9 o'clock and then call family cabins, because I think I'm going to stay in their cabin for the next two nights because it's supposed to rain really bad this afternoon and tomorrow afternoon. So the weather took a turn for the worse. It wasn't supposed to be like this. It was supposed to be sunny, but oh well, that's the risk you take when you come in September, right? So I'm gonna pack up my little tent here. I'm gonna get going, but we're gonna go check out the springs and I'll see you whenever we do that. All right. Well, I made it down to the springs area. I'm just gonna go check it out. Looks like people are going for a swim. I might join them. Just gonna go look at it, feel it, see if I want to or not first, and then yeah, we'll see how beautiful this thing is. Very gorgeous area. It's just too bad the sun wasn't out, but might need to take a swim now before the rain, because I don't know if I'm gonna get good weather during this trip, but we'll see. All right, let's go check it out. I'm gonna go get my bathing suit on. I don't have a towel though, that's the problem. forgot to bring a towel. Like, who does that on a swimming trip? But let me go get the towel. Or my bathing suit on, I mean. Looks gorgeous. Just imagine what it would look like with the sun out. Look at these trees. Yeah, definitely gotta get in there. Probably help cool me off anyways. So let me get changed and then we'll go in.
It feels cold.
It's a little relative.
Are you gonna go right in?
Hey, that's a bad thing.
Oh, man.
I've jumped in the Arctic a couple of times.
Oh.
Pretty.
You definitely,
Woo!
Hardy.
Yeah. You gotta be when you're up in the north, I guess.
Yeah.
This is kind of cold, though. Oh, this water's beautiful. Beautiful. Definitely enjoy my time here for a while. Oh, look, I can stand here. And then I guess afterwards I'll call soon about that cabin or figure out what I'm doing, because I don't have a place to stay tonight or tomorrow night yet, but we'll see. Okay, I'm gonna swim around for a bit. I might show you some stuff, and other than that, I guess I'll see you later. Look how clear this is. If the sun was out, this would be like, it is stunning still, but holy crap, I can just imagine how blue this would be when the sun goes. Hopefully I get one sunny day at the springs. Wow, look at that. Wow. Amazing. I really caught it with the sun out. Super nice. Okay, well, I've decided that Jenny Springs is too far for me to want to go to because it's a 3-hour drive one way. And I'm in a big Hemi truck, so it's a lot of gas and everything. So I'm gonna stay here at Wikiwa, or however you pronounce it, spring until the 1 o'clock close time for me anyways, check out. So I'm just taking a walk down the boardwalk here that's at the state park. It's so beautiful and I just entered it now. So I'm gonna take a quick walk down here, and then after that I might put my bathing suit back on and go for a walk. And once that's going, it's supposed to start raining this afternoon. So I'll start heading to my hotel. I decided to get a hotel for the next 2 nights before I stay at another campsite, just because of the weather. And the place that I wanted to rent for the cabin, I was gonna get a cabin instead of a camp, but it turns out that it's just as much money as the hotel is, so I might as well stay somewhere with AC and linens and everything for the same price. So the camping trip is only gonna be half a camping trip, I guess, because only 3 nights out of the 5 are actually going to be camping, but that's okay. I'm a go with the flow type person right now anyways. Wow, look at all the palms and stuff. It's just gorgeous. So like I said, I'm going to take a walk through here, and then I'm going to probably hop back in the spring. So just thought I'd give you guys an update of what's happening and show you a bit of this trail that I'm walking on. And then after that, I guess we'll pick you back up. Well, I'll show you as I'm walking, but I'll pick you back up and talk to you once later on in the day when something new comes up. All right. Look at that. So cool. So cool. The boardwalk just goes on and on and on. Well, it's all about the trail I'm going to show you, because I'm just going to soak this all in and head back for a swim. Okay, later. Look, I don't know if you guys can see this, but look, there's fish in the water. Tempted to take a kayak, to rent a kayak now and go down the river, but we'll see. We'll see what's up. All right. Cute little lizards. Okay, I'm done swimming. Now I'm just gonna go get changed and figure out what I'm doing. And then I'll let you know. Okay, well, got changed, made it back to the truck. Gonna change my shirt once I get to where I'm going, I guess. Or maybe I'll choose one now, I don't know. Just gonna brush my hair since I didn't forget a brush this trip. So this time, I didn't forget the brush, I just forgot the towel, even though this is supposed to be a swimming vacation. So I think I'm gonna stop at like Walmart or whatever stores are in the States to grab a towel quickly for the next springs. I'm gonna try to go to Wikiwachi, I believe it's called, for tomorrow and rent a canoe or kayak. Not a canoe, a kayak, to go up the river there. And yeah, so that's what I'm up to. I was debating because the weather lied. It was supposed to be raining by now, but it no longer looks like it's gonna rain. So I was gonna cancel the hotel that I got and get another campsite. But you know what? I'm just gonna keep the hotel because it's by Wikiwachi anyways. And it'll be kind of nice to sleep in a real bed tonight, since I don't have a sleeping pad or anything. But then I still got two more nights of camping after that anyways, so yeah, that's what's happening. So I'm heading out, gotta figure out where I'm going to pick up said stuff, and then I'll be on my way. Keep you updated as I go along. Alright, fun day so far. I love this spring. It's very, very beautiful. I'm glad the sun came out. I got to see it in all its glory and everything. It is very busy now, so weekends It is busy, so if you can come during a weekday, that would be better, or early in the morning. But yeah, so far so good. This trip's going amazing. It's only day one, really, because I landed at like, well, I landed at 2:30, but I got the car at 5, so really it's a day and a half in, and so far so good. So yeah, keep you posted. On the countryside, heading to Brooksville. Alright, I'll see you whenever I get there. I still got like another 50 minutes or so, and I'll be over there. They have tree farming in like rows of squares for like as far as the eyes can see. I'm a little late now, but man, oh man. Oh no, it continues over here. Like, that's a lot of land just to use for trees. Like, look at the squares. Never seen anything like it. Well, made it to Brighton. Still have another 33 minutes to go. Cute little town. After passing all of them trees, wish I would have caught that. There was like a massive wall of vines going up the side of the road. It was pretty huge, pretty cool. So I'm making my way slowly but surely. I don't know if I said anything yet, but I've changed my mind about going to Ginny Springs and stuff. I'm going to Brooksville so I can stay at a hotel, because I'm going to go to Wikiwachi and they don't have a campground, so I'm just going to do that. And I was going to stay at another campsite, but the weather network says it's supposed to be pretty shitty tonight. Even though it's been wrong so far, it's supposed to be absolutely downpouring right now, and it's not. So maybe I should have stayed at the campsite, but oh well, it'll be nice to sleep in a bed tonight, and it's right by the Wikiwachi, so I'll get up nice and early and head there, pack some snacks, bought myself a little bit of wine, have myself a little bit of wine tonight, and chill, watch TV. I'm gonna see what there is to see in Brooksville. Hopefully there's something, like a park or something, that I can take a walk in, and I bought myself some milk for some cereal since I'll have a fridge for the next two nights. And then after that, I am going to the Rainbow Springs, Florida campground to have another two nights, so it's not that bad. I'm supposed to camp the whole time, but whatever, plans change. That's the joy of not having anything booked and also traveling by myself. I guess I can just change my mind on a dime and do whatever the hell I want, so that's what's going on. But so far the drive is good. Gas isn't going down too quickly, thank God. It's the only downside about having, that's another reason why I actually changed my mind about going to Ginny Springs, because it's a 3-hour drive one way, and with this truck, if I had a car that was good on gas, it wouldn't be so bad, but with this truck, I don't want to spend the extra time and the extra money to go there. So if I ever come back to Florida, I'll just have to go to North Florida and check that place out another time. So I'm just heading towards the West Coast now. And if there's anything else to see, then I'll point the camera. Other than that, I might pick you up just whenever I hit the hotel. We'll find out though. Bye. Well, looks like we got a train going by. They got some major road work happening here. I don't know how they build their roads here in Florida, but that's pretty neat. Almost looks like, looked like tires at first, but it looks like it's just square metal grates now with some sort of black material or whatever. But just sitting here waiting for the train, about 7 minutes away from the hotel. I'm at a stop, so no biggie. But yeah, check that out. Road's been pretty good so far. It's really weird to be looking at like US speeds instead of Canadian speeds, but getting used to it. Not too bad. Getting used to this big truck too. I think I got it. Well, I know I've got it. It's just kind of silly of me to be so worried about driving it at first, but hey, it is what it is. But I'm just gonna wait for the train, and then 7 minutes, we'll be there. And then I gotta go to the dollar store to get myself a bowl because I bought cereal, but I don't have anything to eat it in. I have plates, like I brought plates for like the camping thing, but I was only expecting to have oatmeal, which doesn't really require a bowl. So, yeah, that is what it is. All right, see you soon. Okay, made it to the Days Inn. Well, it looks like not too shabby. I'm on the second floor, so I gotta go in up the stairs and check out my room. And then I'll bring up my groceries and stuff that I have. They said I have a fridge, so hopefully I do. Because... oh, there's the stairs. Couldn't find the stairs. So hopefully I have a fridge because I have milk and stuff. And... $2.58. One of those hotels where you come in from the outside. It's alright. Better than paying double the price, I suppose, depending on what it's like inside, I guess, but I'm about to find out. Here we go. Well, first impressions, it's a motel room, that's for sure. But it has a little bit of a funky, like it doesn't smell bad, it just doesn't smell, I don't know, maybe it's just me. But anyways, so I'm here. This is my home for the next 2 nights. So I guess I'll just find out what there is to do around here, bring up my bag. Let me check out the bathroom, because I definitely want to shower tonight. Oh, let's do it. It's a shower, it'll do. Don't need nothing fancy when all we're doing is sleeping, right? So, and then a little lobby room to get ready, I guess. Sweet, and then there's air conditioning, so that'll help. Okay, well let me go get my stuff and then I'll pick you back up later once I decide what I'm gonna do. Whoa, there's like these huge birds. Check them out. Wow. Hey, buddy. Wow, what the heck are those? Well, just a quick update. I made it into the motel pool. It's a pretty nice pool. I got it all to myself. As you can see, the nice palm trees. I absolutely love that tree with all the moss hanging, or whatever they call it, lichen moss hanging from the tree up there. Oh, love it. Came here a little bit earlier. There was a bunch of kids. Not that that bothered me, but I wasn't ready to swim. And now I am ready, as you can tell. And I got it all to myself. Fantastic. So I'm just going to swim for a bit and then I'm going to go to the dollar store so I can get myself a bowl. I think I'm just going to eat cereal for supper tonight. Save my other stuff for when I'm back at camp. And I have milk that I need to drink within like tomorrow and stuff. So just thought I'd give you an update and show you the beauty. This is the motel here. The beautiful pool that I'm in. And yeah, so... probably all I'm going to do for the night, talking to a couple of friends on the phone, and then I'm just going to watch TV, chill, and that's about it. So I guess this is it for today, and I will catch you in the morning. Oh, the Wikiwachi canoes are fully booked, so I need to figure that out as well, if I'm going to go Sunday or rent from another company. But yeah, so...